afternoon, guys. We're here down on Raker Lakes in York. It's one of my regular lakes. You might be able to hear it is really, really belting it down. Quite wet, but I've set up and I'm in peg 12. One of the lucky pegs. I've had quite a lot of fish out of peg 12. Fish just popped there, right on top of one of my baits. Been here about maybe an hour. It's now 10 to 2. Pretty dark, but there's loads of fish topping out. Must have seen 10 to 12. So I'm quite confident in a bite. And I'll just turn around and show you where I'm swimming. Showing me swim.
That's peg 12. So you might be able to see just in the distance there, I've got one about 12 feet back off the end of that island. I've got another on a bar around about there. Seem to get quite a lot of bites from there. I've also got one tucked right the way around the corner around there towards the inlet of another island, which produces quite a few fish. It's like I say, really, really wet day, and it's forecast for today, tomorrow and Friday. So we'll see how it goes. Fingers crossed. I'm using 15mm cell bottom baits on one rod, and I've got pineapple pop-ups on two of my other rods. I've spotted out to the one I said I've got over here. Put maybe 10-15 spots out there, and mix a bit of sweet corn and a bit of pellet, crush some cell up, and a bit of hook bait enhancer tipped in with it. Quite smelly, but yeah, I've had a couple of liners up there now. Like I said, there's one just topped out on my bait, so fingers crossed.
I'm hoping not to get wet, but to fish that spot in the island round the corner, I've had to put my waders on and get in. I haven't used my waders since 3 weeks ago, and as soon as I put them on, they were just full of water. So I'm now currently sat with no socks, which is always fun. But yeah, Raker Lakes, York. Hopefully good for a bite or two. The best I've done in this swim ever, I've had 13 fish in 36 hours. Biggest being around about 22. I've had the lake record out of peg 1 about 5 years ago at 29.5 pounds split tail. It's obviously bigger fish in here now. She's probably a lot bigger now. Some right old warriors in here. I've had a couple of really good 25, 26 pounders out of here. They're really good stamp of fish. It's well looked after. I was on the fish quite good. You can see the anglers are doing what they can. Yeah, I think there's a good head of carp in here. There's over 300, 300 or 400 fish. So loads of 20s. So I'm hoping for a 20 and not a blank. Try and change things around after tonight if there's nothing comes. But fingers crossed I will get something, so have faith. And I'll see you guys when I catch a fish. If I catch a fish. I'll maybe show you my rigs. Show you what I'm doing. Catch you in a bit. So I've literally had my rod in the water for about an hour and a half, and I've had a 20 pound 4 ounce mirror from the one round the corner. Came in with the biggest snag I have ever seen. It must be 6 foot long and an inch thick. Yeah, really, really happy with that. That was on cell bottom baits with a bottom bait rig. A tiny bag of pellets and a couple of crushed boilers in it. That was fish right tight up to the reeds. But hopefully, rods back out, get a couple more. Guys, just had a 20 pound 4 ounce mirror from the spot just round the corner, the awkward cast as I call it. Come in with the biggest snag I have ever seen or played a fish on. It must be 6 foot long and an inch thick. You could make a walking stick out of it. Happy days, we've had a fish within a couple of hours of being here, so I'm quite confident there could be more. Loads of fish chopping out, and a couple more in my area over where I've been spotting. I say spotting, I don't like to put loads of spot mix out, but just enough, maybe it's about a kilo. A couple of handfuls of boilies over the top. say there is a lot of fish shown all over the lake. I mean, I'm in peg 12 and there's pretty much nobody on this side, so there's nobody in 10 and 11, there's nobody in 13 and 14. There's a guy in 15, but I don't think he's had anything. I think there was a couple of fish out last night in the 20s. So, hopefully for a bite tonight. Fingers crossed. It's dark early tonight, so we'll see what goes on. Let me just show you this snag. That's the snag. It was enormous. How it came in, it was like trying to create an elephant. But we got it in. Like I say, just where them reeds are, just over there. It's an awkward cast because of this tree, so you've got to kind of side cast it, which is quite awkward. But I've brought my waders, so all is good. And it's getting quite cold and all, hence the woolly hat. Winter's coming now. But I'm confident with all three rods where we are. They're all on quite decent spots. Enjoy the time that you're fishing. Summer's gone now, so it's about the fully clothed bed chair cover, thick sleeping bag. It was only a month ago I was in France. It was 40 degrees and I was sleeping in me boxer shorts because it was that hot. I think I lost like half a stone. Couldn't keep the water going in us, and that went on for like 5 days. But we had some good fishing. Some of the best fishing I've ever had, really. Smashing PBs. Yeah. But good old English weather. For the English carper, that's what I like. I fished Raker Lakes when it's frozen over and it's been -3, -4, and caught a fish to boot, which was about £13 common. That was peg one again, did think about doing peg 1, but peg 12, if you can get on Raker Lakes and you pre-boog it, peg 12 is a peg to be in. For some strange reason they like to hold up in this big bay. When I first got here there was Lord Sean and Steve, the owner, he came round and he said they're holding up mid-water. I think I scared them away, but it's been a couple of hours now of quietness, so you can actually see just a little bit of bubbles coming up on me baited spot. So happy days. Let's hope for the big girl, as they say. But yeah, it's a waiting game. Patience is a virtue. Just flip your arm and see if you can pick out the bubbles. Some bubbles, 16 wraps away, but yeah, I mean, to look at the other side, the wind's blowing down the other side, like a river, but it's calm, calm as anything around here. So hopefully I've made the right choice. Well, I've had one fish within a couple of hours, so that tells me I have, so hey ho, and I'm sure I'll show you if I have any more. And I'll catch you in a bit. So it's finally stopped raining. Since I got here yesterday morning, really bad throughout the night, couldn't sleep, it's like being in a tin can, but the weather said it was going to rain all day today, but just checked, and as you can see now, it's a lovely morning. No fish through the night, but there's still time left yet. Just literally had liners on both my middle and my right hand rod. Shows that they're moving around. I thought I missed one this morning, but I think it's just a big liner. Some had swum into my line, but I'm using flying back leads, so they're quite close in if they're moving. It's about 12:30, day two. It's about maybe 2 hours time I had a bite yesterday. So fingers crossed, it's bite time again soon. Decided to change over, change tactics. I've gone onto a bottom bait on all rods with a small PVA bag of pellets and crushed pivies. I don't fish full whole bottom bait, I always cut them in half and put them back to back. Just something I've always done. I'd rather do that than fish a full body. Again, it's whatever you've got confidence in. It's always worked for me, so that's what I had the fish on yesterday. What more can you ask for? Keep doing what you're doing. There's been a lot of fish boshing out in the night. Couldn't quite tell where they were. It's the rain. But quite hopeful for a bite last night, but nothing came. Not even a bait. But it did rain quite heavy. Got soaked. If today's looking like a better day. There's quite a few patches of bubbles shown. Some guys have just moved into the next swim, 11 and 10. Hopefully that might chase them down this way a bit. It's said to see a lot of fish shown in their swim when I came and took my rods out. so hopefully split them up a bit. Another six lines in the water. It's quite a pressured fishery this. The guy who was on 15's just been around for a chat, just to go over what he's sort of doing. He's lost two this morning, he said, but I mean, I've had some real good luck in 15 before. Caught split tail in 15 at 29.5 pound, which has been my UK PB for quite a while now. So I'd love to beat it. I'll catch it again at a bigger size. He's kind of tearing his hair out thinking, what can he do? But don't think he's doing anything wrong. He's got two on the island and one near the aerator, which I've had. That's where I had split tail from, on the aerator. So I think he's in good places. But you just mind works overtime when you don't want to blank. Luckily for me, I'm not blanking. Which could be worse. All in all, got another 24 hours to go to get another run. The weather's taking a better course than I thought. Sun's out. Yeah, fingers crossed for another run. It is a lovely little place. I always like fishing here. Thought I'd show you my bait, what I've been putting in. Not a great deal, like, just pellets and sweetcorn, a load of cell additive. I've not really been putting loads of bait in, but just enough to get them feeding a little bit. There's not much going on at the minute, but as for the weatherman, he hasn't got it close this time. Said it was going to rain for 3 days, but at the minute the sun is cracking the floor, blue skies, clouds all breaking up, feel the temperature going up. Just a couple of things to mention about Raker now is they've got these sort of astroturf in the swim, makes it a lot more tidy and a lot more cleaner. It's a very good idea. And another thing to add is we've now got these weir pegs, which is a very good idea. I think all swims should have them, or all fisheries should have them. And it's even had it made as a carp. Nice little detail. Let's see, all fisheries should have them. I know they do out in France, a lot of them. It just saves you messing on trying to hold a fish up and look at the scales at the same time. Saves you a lot of trouble, especially in the night. Can make a big difference. But yeah, things is looking very carpy out there now. Very, very fishy. I'm getting quite confident as a bite. There's a lot of air bubbles coming up here and there. Keep getting liners. keep getting liners. Although I'm using flying backheads, but yeah, there's been a couple of fish shown in that cut through there. I think the guy in the next room up just brought his rod in. I think he's going to put it out there. Which, if there was nobody in that room, I think I would be. There you go, he's right on the corner. But, yeah. Looking good at the minute. So I just thought I'd show you my rig, what I'm using. This is my bottom bait rig, what I use almost everywhere. There's not much changes on it, but the length. I'm using a size 8 korda curve shank. A bit of silicone to trap the hair. And a liner. And I'm always using rig putty now instead of the korda sinkers, which I find you only get two uses out of them and then you're pretty much done, and you always discolour, so I trust the rig putty a bit more and you can use it as many times as you want. We're about 8 inches long, which is a little bit over what I normally sort of length. It's quite silty in here, so I'm going for that little bit longer. The hook link material is Avid Captive in gravel, which is a little bit lighter than I normally use, but it seems okay. This is what I had the 20 pounder on earlier on. Always use 2 half baits, just what I've got confidence in, and they're 2 cell 15 mil bottom baits, what I've sort of cut in half, and then I'll put the rig into the glug for a couple of hours before I use it. Just what I've got confidence in, what I've caught a lot of fish on. Very simple rig, easy to tie, quick to tie. I'm not one for these who sort of jump on the bandwagon of the likes of the Chod and the Ronnie rig. Very good rigs, but I think they've been overused. Everybody you talk to, it's always the same. I've got a Choddy or I've got a flipper rig, as they call it. I'm not gonna lie, I have got some tied up, but my confidence comes from what I've used. I like to keep things simple and do what I know rather than what somebody else knows. I won't get as long, I like a few tips, but you can't beat making your own things and catching on them. Yeah, so that's my bottom bait rig. My other rig is a multi rig, what I normally use. Sort of with a pop up. Again, I've caught loads of fish on it on the multi rig, so masses of confidence in it. I suppose it's just like a Chod rig or a flipper rig. It's come from somebody else, it's not one of my own. But I like to think I make my own adjustments on it, and it works well. So they're my two rigs, what I use for fishing 99% of the time. It's not very often I fish zigs, no confidence in them whatsoever. I very rarely fish with a Chod unless there's lots and lots of weed, and that would only be the time I go to retard. But sometimes I'd rather use a solid PVA bag for weed fishing. Just get it in through the weed. But yeah, things is quiet. There's a lot of bubbles still. The weather's still looking good. Fingers crossed. Things are starting to dry out a bit. We've not heard anybody getting anything at the minute. Pretty quiet around the lake. You might be able to hear that pigeon, which has basically kept me up all night. If I could see it, I'd hit it with a catapult, no problem. But apart from that, things are looking good. One thing to take into account when you come and fish on Raker is there's quite a lot of silt pockets. If you don't sort of feel your lead down or even get the marker out and avoid them, you will plunge into them quite deep, at least 4 inches. You need to take that into account when you're making your rigs or when you're casting. Like I say, it's quite weird, sort of muddy clay silt mixed together. The bottom's very soft. The one I had the weirdest on yesterday almost got stuck in it. But you can find the clay areas. That's one thing I will say, the fish do make the clay areas. So if you can find them, you can be on the fish. I think it's just a matter of time. So yeah. spot to take. Or a vicious liner. Bob and just smacked up to the paper, to the paper ladder. And dropped back down. So when I've hit it, nothing there. Just had a mad sort of a small storm, just hail storming and raining at the same time, and there was thunder, and as you can see now the sun's back out, looks like a summer's day. So that's me, one in the net and sort of lost one, which I'm hoping that they're still out there and they're still going to feed. Plenty of time left yet. I've got about 15 hours left. That's plenty of time to bag another one. Been a fish show on like the boundary between me and the next swim up. So I think I'll put a rod on that. And then the guy in the next swim up, he started exactly the same, and I put a rod on that. Almost at the same time, we both tried to put a rod right next to him and realised what's going on. So put the rod back to where it was. I'll let the guys do it then. So, good day done for the day. It's no good two of us fishing it so close together. If we get a run, it might wrap together. And I'm not down for that, so. Slow, I'm still quite confident. Still fingers crossed for a bite. Bar the one that's just shown on the boundary. It's not much shown now. So it's just it's a waiting game at the moment. It seems as though everybody on the whole lake's just sort of reeled in and recast. Great stuff. Guys, so I've just had another sort of 21-2 mirror, beautiful mirror with the big scales, about an hour ago, which it's 7 o'clock now, about 5 to 6, just before light. Went through all the two of my rods, so kind of thought, right, I might as well pack it in now. I was going to go at 10 o'clock, so I'm not going to start sorting everything out for another hour's fishing. I'm happy with what I've got. I had another run last night, but there was nothing there when I lifted the rod up, so I'm quite happy with that. Quite happy with the 220s. Obviously, I'll put the pictures on. Just to show you. But yeah, bottom bait rig works like a charm. The method, two half baits and a little bag of half boilies, always goes great. Starting to feel a lot colder now in the morning, really cold this morning, so winter's coming. Yeah, let's get packed up and get back on the road and get home, get a shower, because I'm stinking. That's one thing about Raker, is there's no showers down here. There's a toilet and a sink in a little old cabin, but that is your lot. So I'll be pleased to get home and get a good shower, and I'll see you guys on the next trip out. Thanks for watching. Cheers.